Here at, I'm Dennis. I'm from Cologne, but I graduated at the Max Planck Institute for Marine Microbiology in Bremen in 2011. And then I quit science and I became my own boss in my own company. And I would like to introduce to you today the idea of a Max Planck Alumni Association, tell you why I think this is a great idea and a little bit about the structure that this association will have. And I would like to start with my own story because it links to the fact why I think that this is a great idea. So, bridging the gap between academia and industry. This was me, 2011, graduating. As you can see on the top of my PhD, it is a deep black smoker because I was doing deep sea research on black smokers. It was a really good time, but I decided not to stay in science, but rather to get together with a friend of mine who graduated in bioinformatics and create a company based on a stipend which we got from the BMBF. And what we do is we create all kind of content for science communication, so videos, websites, animation, anything that the researchers, that the scientists can use to get their science either to other people, to the public, or to other scientists. And also these soft skill courses that Martin was talking about make like a third of what we're doing is offering these soft skill courses, enabling students to work with Photoshop and Illustrator, teach them how to do science communication. So as you heard, there's still some money left in PhDNet. If you need some training, please get in touch. But now, of course, the question is, why is a Max Planck Alumni Association a great idea? When I had the idea to start my own company, the problem was I did not have any network. And you guys need a network. If you talk to anyone at career fairs or in these courses, every time they will tell you, start networking yesterday. It is important. It is independent where you go after your PhD, if you stay in academia, if you go into industry, if you create your own company, it doesn't matter. You need a huge network, otherwise this will not work out. So networking is the most important thing. And suddenly, the presentation will go on. In no time. So, networking. This was 2 weeks ago here at the Max Planck Alumni Association meeting. You need this. And if you have ever been in the position that you already applied for a job or you were about to apply for a job, you try to get in contact with someone you have never met. It is almost impossible to get in touch with these higher people in industry, even in academia, if you have no link to them. So if anyone already tried, email this person or cold calling these people, it's almost impossible to get through if you don't have any link to them, if you are completely not known to them. And this is why I think that the Max Planck Alumni Association is a great idea. I would love to have this at my time when I needed a network, because it already creates this tiny link. If you need to talk to someone, maybe this one is or has been associated with the Max Planck network. We had people here from Merck and Bosch, right, that they were alumni. It makes it way easier just to tell them in the email or when you call them, mention that you also are at an MPI. Just this tiny detail is already a little door opener that helps you a lot, believe me. So, Max Planck Alumni Association, where did the idea come from, or where did everything start? We had the idea of a circle of friends already here in 1989, called the Harnack Principle, and there was an MPI-oriented community building going on. Then I'm sure all of you know MaxNet, which was created in 2007. And then an alumni concept sparked in 2011. They were thinking about international branding, the extensions of the services to the alumni as ambassadors that can go abroad and talk about the story, and to create a Max Planck Alumni Association. So what would be the benefit of such an association? Well, the community building, we have almost 100,000 alumni. We could bring into the network worldwide, about 40% of them are abroad. There will be local communities at each MPI if people want to get together and in and outside of academia. And the vision would be to create a value-driven independent association, so an eingetragener Verein, an e.V., which supports its members with services, supervises, and is, of course, supported by the Max Planck Society. What could this Max Planck Alumni Association do for you guys? As I said, what I think is most important is concerning to help you to develop your career. So in terms of career strategy, mentoring, trainings, lifelong learning, even getting a goodbye and welcome package when you come or leave at the MPI, get an email address, because for example, when you leave an MPI, you leave your email address there, 107.gmail.com or whatever. Maybe 4 years later, someone wants to get in touch with you, but they only have this old email address. So we would like to make sure everyone gets a dedicated email address for these purposes and access to facilities. Who would be in? The good news is all of you. So we would say that alumni are whoever has been in touch, has been linked, has worked at an MPI for more than 6 months. It doesn't matter if student, PhD, postdoc, PI, anyone who has been related to an MPI for more than 6 months. And the membership is also extended to current affiliates, which means also people who are now still working at an MPI are also happy and welcome in the MPI, in the Max Planck Alumni Association. You can already write down this link. The website is in progress. I will come to this. Now about the structure, it's really similar to, for example, the PhDNet. So there will be groups which are self-organized communities in the Max Planck Alumni Association. Every group has its own chair, its own board, statute, funds, but they're not independent associations. They belong to the MPAA. And each group has then its own mission and a strategic plan. Then there are assembly delegates, so which means each group elects an assembly delegate and on a 3-year term. The assembly is a democratic organ, so they meet, and then they decide on the mission, the amendments of the statute, and the strategic plan, and so on and so on. So the stuff that you already know about. It's a really common structure to these associations. Then there is the board, which is the executive organ of the organization and supervises and realizes the strategic plan. It is composed of 15 members. 2 members are elected per year, 2 members appointed per year. I will be general secretary at the 1st of October when this whole thing goes live. And the mandate is on a 3-year term with 1-year term limit and 2-year term for the chair, which is Filippo, just once. So now to sum it up again, so the members, potentially up to 100,000 running around on this globe, we could feed into this network and make accessible to one another. Then there are the groups, then there is the assembly, and then there is the board. So the plan is then also to host a Max Planck symposium for alumni and early stage researchers on a 2-year, on a 1-year basis, which take 2-day yearly meeting of all alumni and active researchers and is preceded by a 1-day MPAA assembly. We already did one 3 weeks ago with more than 200 participants, half of them alumni, half of them active scientists, and they were from all over the place. We had networking, career fair, and so on and so on. So what's the status quo now? The MPAA is registered. Actually, 3 days ago, I got the email from Filippo, so it's now everything is official and clear, and it will start 1st of October. The initial, so we will now try it out, which means initial membership is given to some people. We start with 50 people, then 100, and then we grow it and grow it and see if the platform is stable enough to sustain everything. The landing page is already working. You can already go there and find the links to the LinkedIn group, the Facebook group, the Twitter feed, so you can link with the MPAA and stay in touch and see when we open for registration, which will also happen on the mpg-alumni.de page. This is how the landing page looks like. Not much yet, but as I said, there are these links to the social networks, and we have them on LinkedIn, on Facebook, on Twitter, and there are even some regional groups already popping up and organizing themselves. And this is the end of my short introduction to the Max Planck Alumni Association. If you have any questions, please address them now to me or later on to Birgit or Johanna. And I'm looking forward to see you all in the Max Planck Alumni Association soon. Thank you for your attention. Do you guys have any questions?
Exactly.
So you said that there are some limitations for current researchers to join. Maybe I didn't get it, but what are the limitations?
So no, there are no limitations.
Because it was on the slide, like with limitations, was written there.
Sorry. What? No. So if it was on the slide, it was wrong. There is no limitation for current researchers. So you all can join.
Okay.
Once the registration process is open, which I'm building, so maybe another month, and then we're good to go, and the testing is complete.
Right.
6 months? Invitation? No. What? And if you, yes, exactly, exactly. This is the limitation. You have to be associated with Max Planck for 6 months. So if you just started, right, if you just started, you need to wait a bit more.
Okay. And you said you would help with research, with career development or career strategy. So the Alumni Association also does this for current researchers if they will soon become alumni. Okay.
Yes. Okay. So we don't distinguish in are you already an alumni or how long have you been alumni for. All the services, especially the career service, are open also to active people. It makes just more sense. So we cannot tell people, no, you have to wait until you're done and then we help you, because you have to actually start, let's say, the last half year of your PhD or even earlier. You have to start. If you just start after your PhD, it's too late, so definitely help them as early as possible.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, welcome.
Do we have any more questions for Dennis?
So Dennis, how do you think we can establish a good platform to collaborate with PhDNet and MPA?
I think the best way is, so I think people have to realize where they are, because we have a lot of these organs, like we have the MaxNet, we have the PhDNet, and we have an MPAA. People might get confused where to go or where to ask for help. So what we have to make sure is, if people want help, if people are looking for something, that it is crystal clear where they can get this. So once the website is done, or once we create these groups also on the website, I suggest that we sit down as the steerers of these platforms and find a way where we make it as easy as possible for people, so that they don't have to look around or ask themselves, okay, I want to host the Visions and Science, where do I have to ask, or I just want some advice, or I want a soft skill course, whom to contact. So it should be crystal clear where to get help, and I suggest we all sit down and think about a structure or how to make it really clear for people where they can find this. But of course, a link will make, this is the best idea, of course, yeah. So they have to be linked, yeah.
Good, so do we have, maybe we have time for just one more question?
So, Philip, I think one of the interesting thing is that we already, in last 2 years, established this career fair, and it's already established. People also know, different companies also know that this career fair established. So it would be great that both the organization push this forward together.
Exactly.
At this platform, and I think it will be very, very helpful to all the PhDs and postdocs.
Exactly. So if there is already this knowledge on companies or these data, then of course it makes sense not to invent the wheel twice, but pool all information, knowledge, and make the best of it for the PhDs. This is what we're doing. So this is the main purpose, that we enable PhDs, make it easier to get in touch with each other, get in touch with companies. So definitely not inventing the wheel twice, maximizing the knowledge. Yeah.
Yeah, and I think in regards not inventing the wheel twice, we should really build up on this very good organization of doctoral researchers. Yeah, that is already in place. So. And this shouldn't be done the second time, yeah, because also many active doctoral researchers will join MPAA. So there should be a clear boundary, so to say, yeah, where
exactly.
We establish the link between PhDNet and MPAA.
Yeah, so we are, of course, looking how other alumni associations are working, what are they doing. We are also open on feedback, so what are people actually want, how they want to use the platform. So we are talking to people from Yale, who have an incredible alumni network there. So just to make sure that we create something people actually want to use and not just log in, register, and then don't come back again because they don't see any value. We want to make sure that people use this.
Good. Okay, please.
Thank you, guys.
Yes. With everybody. We thank you once more.
Wow, thanks.
You're welcome.
And I did not come by plane, so I can take it.
Fantastic. That is how it's meant to be. And now, next session.